Hello everyone, Halloween is here, let's get technical. Wait a sec, I need to costume up. Ah, that's better. Okay, I know Newt's Commander is a Hufflepuff, but I will not be caught dead wearing any memorabilia from a house other than my superb Slytherin. And I know a lot of people here on Technicality agree with me.
But you're a Dumbledore one year for Halloween!
Shut up! That man is a saint! Wow, that got off topic really, really quickly. Where was I? Oh yeah, it's that time of year again. Pumpkins are on doorsteps, kids gobble candy, and we Americans spend about $6.9 billion averaging 74 bucks a person on Halloween. So, because today is October 31st, and who doesn't love some good science experiments, let's do three spooky DIY science experiments. Number one, epic ghost bubbles. I gotta put these back. What you'll need for this experiment is some warm water, dish soap, a cup, a dry towel, a cotton glove, a heavy-duty glove, or something that you can use to pick up really hot or really cold stuff, dry ice, and this, which is called a bubble generator. But it's also known as a couple of other things. Don't worry, there'll be links to get that and everything else in this video down in the description below. First, what you need to do is mix the water and soap together in this cup. This will be our bubble solution. Now, this alone is pretty cool. We can make bubbles with it. But we don't want regular bubbles. We want epic ghost bubbles. Time to add in some epic. Pour enough water into the bubble generator so the water line is just below the spigot. Now put the dry ice in the bubble generator. Make sure not to touch it. I repeat, do not touch it. Use your hardcore glove or something like that to put it in. Whoa, that's cool. Now before you cap it off, make sure to put this end into the bubble mix just so you can get some bubble mixture on it. And, whoa. We got ourselves some epic ghost bubbles right here. That's pretty cool. Now, you notice, like that just happened, they tend to pop when they hit the table, so make sure you put down this towel so you can actually maybe keep them around for a little bit more than a couple seconds. Oh, look. Oh, that's so cool. Okay, now here's the really cool part. You should be able to actually hold these bubbles in your hand if you put on these cotton gloves. Let's try it out. Oh, that's cool. Oh, what? You wanna try it, Walker?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, cool. Huh. So what's going on here? Well, dry ice is frozen carbon dioxide. Dry ice is called dry ice because when it gets warmer, it doesn't turn into a liquid, it turns into a gas. That's why it's all steamy. By the way, the fancy name for when a heated solid turns not into a liquid, but directly into a gas is sublimation. When in contact with the warm water, the frigid dry ice, you guess it, heats up. Once you cap off the bubble maker, all of the CO2 gas is caught in the bubble maker. It builds and builds, and eventually, it just can't take it anymore. All of that air pressure forces the gas to come out of this tube, right where the bubble mix is waiting for it.
Dude from Technicality, that's neat, but why do I have to wear those gloves when I'm handling the bubble? Will the bubble freeze my hand off or something?
No, it's perfectly fine to touch the bubble. Boop. But handling them with your cotton gloves protects the bubbles from all the dirt and oil that's on your hands, which can pop the bubble. Also, one more thing. If you actually do this experiment, you'll notice that the bubbles don't really seem like bubbles. They're a lot heavier. Wow, that's heavy. That's because CO2 is a lot heavier than regular air, giving those ghost bubbles a little more weight. And that's the experiment. These mysterious epic ghost bubbles will be a hit at any Halloween party. Number two. The CO2 Candle Putter-Outer. You'll need baking soda, vinegar, 2 cups, and a lit candle. Bonus points for a festive pumpkin-scented candle. I guess this experiment's gonna be lit. Okay, I'll stop. Anywho, first mix the baking soda and the vinegar. Make sure you pour just enough so that the bubbles fill all the way up to the top. Thanks to the reaction that just happened, this cup is now filled with carbon dioxide, or CO2. Now, we need to get all the CO2 gas that we just made into the other cup, so tilt the cup over like this. Don't pour any liquid in it. The CO2 gas goes into the other cup and stays in the other cup because it's heavier than the air around it. It's going to look like you're doing nothing, but trust me, you are doing it right.
Thanks, man.
Finally, the big moment has arrived. Pour your cup of CO2 over the flame and watch it go out like magic. That was pretty cool. Okay, so now that we know the trick, let's explore the science behind it. So first off, why does mixing vinegar and baking soda magically create the CO2 we need to put out the candle? Well, it's not magic, it's science. More specifically, it's a Bronson-Lowry acid-based reaction.
Whoa, 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 slow down there, son.
What even is that?
Johannes Nicholas Bronsted and Thomas Martin Lowry were two chemists who both independently created this definition for how acids and bases react to each other back in 1923. There are a couple other kinds of acid-base reactions, but those aren't important right now. A Bronsted-Lowry acid-base reaction is a reaction that happens between compounds. These could be ionic compounds, covalent compounds, anything is fair game. The reaction happens when a base takes a hydrogen proton from the acid. Okay, so how does this relate to putting out candles? When we combine vinegar, the acid, with baking soda, the base, the baking soda takes one hydrogen proton from the vinegar. The product of this reaction is carbonic acid, which is H2CO3, which then breaks down into water and carbon dioxide, or H2O and CO2. The water is, in part, the liquid left in the first cup, and the carbon dioxide is the stuff that you pour into the other cup. As we learned from the epic Ghost Bubbles experiment, carbon dioxide is a lot heavier than air, so it should pour nicely onto the flame. Since fire needs oxygen to burn, and the only thing it has is CO2, the flame can't stay alive and goes out. Side note here, fire extinguishers are filled with CO2 for this very reason. It's super effective at putting out fires. Anyways, this also means that if you have dry ice, which is just carbon dioxide so cold it's in its solid form, you could also use that to put out the candle. Well, I guarantee you that your friends will be blown away when you show them this spooky experiment. Number 3, the Shrieking Coin. Did you know that inside every nickel, Thomas Jefferson is trapped, unable to get out, and whenever you press him against dry ice, he shrieks for the world to hear? Wow, that just got really legit. Anywho, so whenever you have a nickel and some dry ice, push the coin on the frozen CO2. Ooh, it's actually getting cold. And this will work with any coin. Whoa. And it gets even creepier. Watch how the coin shivers when I put it in this little slit in the dry ice. Man, if you have some extra dry ice lying around, which, of course, who doesn't, this is a sweet party trick. So I thought this was so cool, I showed it to my friend Dianna from the Physics Girl YouTube channel. Okay, sweet. Here we go.
Love that. Yes.
So, ready?
Oh, cool. I have set a metal spoon against some dry ice before, but I've never used the coin, and I've just done it lightly, and it gets a little vibration going, but I've never pressed it like that. That's an amazing sound that it makes.
That's super cool, but Dianna, do you know why this happens?
Good question, Alex. So, when you put the coin on the dry ice, it causes the dry ice to sublimate. That's because the coin is hot. Well, it's not hot, you know, by our standards, but it's a lot hotter than the dry ice. As the pressure builds up, that CO2 needs to escape somewhere, so it escapes around the sides of the coin, and as it does so, it causes the coin to vibrate, which is that shrieking noise that you hear. It's actually the coin vibrating. So the same thing is true when you put the coin on its side and it shivers, because as the dry ice is sublimating, you're getting these currents around the coin, and those currents are causing the coin to move. That's what's going on.
Thank you so much, Dianna, for explaining that trick. It was really awesome that you could come on the channel. I really appreciate it. And those are the 3 experiments. But before I go, I have a bonus challenge for you. Bonus challenge! Wah! For this bonus challenge, you'll need a tea bag, a plate, a lighter, some scissors, and a pen is optional. I have this ghost right here, which is just a tea bag with the top cut off, and I drew this cute little face on it. Let's see what happens if I light this ghost on fire. Whoa. That's crazy. Here. Can you explain the science behind this? Let me know in a comment down below and subscribe because I'm going to be releasing a video soon that explains this cool trick. Huh. And if you get it right, you and your comment will be featured in an upcoming video. Dianna, do you want to sign off?
Sure, Alex. Thanks for watching DFTBA and explore on.
This video, as you probably noticed, was an awesome collaboration with Dianna from Physics Girl. Follow me over to her channel where she looked at 6 mind-blowing math tricks. Dianna invited me to explain one of the math tricks over in that video. I can't believe I'm gonna be in a Physics Girl video. That's so cool. Thank you so much, Dianna. Click here on the screen with these cool new end cards to watch the video. Dianna has a totally awesome YouTube channel that is legit good. Matter of fact, without her videos, I would have never made Technicality episode 22, which is the one all about the Higgs boson. So go check it out. It's really cool.